Hello, this is Bern, and if you don't have the life that you want, or you're starting over, I'm gonna share with you what it really takes to go from zero to love. So stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship that you've always wanted. And not as a result of gimmicks or manipulation or stupid techniques, but as a result of stepping into the most alive, the most feminine version of yourself. Now, if you find yourself right now starting over, I've been having a hell of a time finding a new partner. And you want to start, the first step of the entire process is to have self-compassion. Why? Because it's so easy to blame yourself in a way that's unhealthy. I'm not saying don't take responsibility for your actions, because that's absolutely bad. But if you don't take the point of view of having self-compassion, prohibits you from moving forward. Also, you need to learn how to step into forgiveness. Why? Because you might have strong levels of anger towards your ex-partner. And so long as you don't forgive that human being, you're going to carry that bitterness, that resentment, that pain, and that baggage to the next relationship. Am I saying that you should actually forget everything that happened? I'm not saying you should forget, because there's a lesson to be learned. But if you take the lesson and the pain, and you don't alchemize the pain into forgiveness, then you will see the next man in your life as the second part of that same guy, even though they may be completely different men, and it's not necessary. Now, when you forgive someone, it's very important for you to remember that it doesn't mean that you're condoning their behavior. It doesn't mean that you're saying it's okay what happened. It's just saying my standard is higher than holding someone in a deep embrace of pain and hoping that my life is great, because that's what you do when you don't forgive someone. You embrace the person you don't forgive in a bitter exchange, and that stops you from getting what you want. Part of what also allows you to forgive is to understand the gift that happened as a result of that experience in such a powerful and courageous way that you don't just say, well, I'll get to my goal despite this thing that happened, but I'll get to my goal because of what happened. Develop a deeper understanding and awareness as a result of what you went through. Number two would be insight. Insight means you need to figure out a way to understand the source of the problem, the source of what's prevented you time and time and time and time and time yet again of not getting the result that you want, connecting to an available man, saying yes to situations that are far less than what you want to experience. Because if you don't understand what the source of the problem is, if you don't find a way to get clear as to what is the problem versus the symptom, then you are doomed to repeat this again and again. One of the best ways I have found to figure out the source of the problem is to get coaching. Why? Because you don't know what you don't know. Your blind spots are exactly that, blind spots. And having someone directly to your face saying, here's exactly what I see, and here's how you can change it, can eliminate 10 years of trial and error all in one scoop. Number three, hard vision. Hard vision means that you need to develop a visceral reason, a visceral path as to why you want to create this relationship. Why do you have to have a visceral vision? Because if you don't have a visceral gut level vision of what you want, this process is so complicated. The path to get what you want is so full of traps and thorns that you're going to quit half along the way, or one third along the way, or one tenth along the way, unless you figure out a bigger reason than yourself even just to have this relationship. Number four is a commitment. Why commitment? Because a lot of human beings want love. Few human beings are committed to doing what it takes to create the love that they want, including the learnings they need to step into, including parts of themselves they need to change, including new openings in their heart and their soul, including better questions they need to ask for partners. Commitment means that I'm not just going to have that high level vision become a wet dream of mine. I'm actually going to do something about it. I'm going to do what it takes to make it happen, to bring it about, to materialize it into form. Number five is, if you have that commitment, you need to create a map. Why? Because otherwise you're going to be like that wild bird that's flying all over the place but not getting anywhere. You need to create a proactive map, meaning what are the things you need to do? What are the emotional states you need to step into? What are the rituals that you need to step into every single day of your life so that you can strengthen your soul and your body and your heart to get it? How is it that you're going to date? What questions you're going to ask? What are going to be the standards that you create when dating? Like, all those things are part of your plan. Second part of your plan means the contingency plan, which is a reactive plan. Why? Because any plan that doesn't have a plan B is doomed to fail, because you will connect to a man and he'll be show up and appear to be the most amazing specimen that you've ever connected with. You'll have a heart level explosion, and then 5 weeks later he'll disappear, never to be seen again. And if your map basically says, well, once that happens, then I should marry the man, and you don't have like, what do I do when a man, not if, when a man disappears, then you're going to be caught off guard. And you want to create a plan that says, not if, but when shit happens, here are my commitments to myself. And here's what I do, and here's how I turn it around. Number six is adjustments, which is part of this, but goes deeper. Adjustments means you need to be flexible on your approach to get that high level goal that you want, but you also need to be willing to adjust the goal if you figure out in getting to know yourself that you want different things. For example, if you start off saying, here's exactly what I want, and I want five children with a man, and then you say, you know what, I actually want no children, that you are courageous enough to do what Gandhi did when he said, my commitment is to truth, not to consistency. Because if your commitment is to truth, which is changing if you develop more insight, then you're not focused on the 1985 version of yourself, which wanted something, and the 2019 wants a different thing, and you're going for that thing that you once said because you now have to make it happen. Be willing to shift your approach from your heart if you figure out something that's more important to you than what you originally set out to create. And last one is more commitment. Why? Because all of the steps are going to have to be rinsed and repeated again and again and again. Until when? A lot of women say, Bern, until when do I have to do this? Until you get what you want. You're going to do this until you get what you want. If that's the level of commitment you have, then that result will come forward and catch you midway. If you're committed to doing it for a month or two or three, and then that's it, then you probably will, that result will elude you for the rest of your life. Hope this is helpful, insightful, and useful. And even though it's not an easy process, it's a simple process. If you find that there's value in what I'm sharing with you right now, I'm asking you right now, my dear, to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel, and if you hit the little bell, you'll be notified of new episodes as they come out. If you want to take these learnings deeper on two different ways. First way is if you just want to learn what it really takes to enter the kind of relationship you want, I create a free masterclass that you can sign up for. Click on the first link under the description of this video, enter in an email, and you'll start watching that masterclass right away. If you're saying to yourself, and you're being really, really, really honest, saying, Bern, this is amazing, I like the way you think, and I like the vision that you outlined for me right now, making it happen is a universal part of understanding it, which is true. And I want your hand-holding and help to get there, because I don't have the luxury of 10 extra years of trial and error to wing this shit and see if it happens. I want to make sure that it happens, and I want to do it in the least convoluted way possible, and with the biggest learnings and insights that I could step into, then I might be able to help. Second link on the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. So fill out an application, and if I'll read it personally, each one of them. If I feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out and set up a time for us to connect. Thank you so much for connecting with me, for allowing me into your heart and into your phone, into your life. And as always, I challenge you, live a full and a conscious life.